This is Marilyn Lohman, Service Hydrologist at WFO Pendleton. I'll be showing some slides of the current snowpack conditions and the expected water supply for the coming spring and summer. Measurements of the snow water equivalent, or amount of water being held in the snowpack, were taken on January 1st for the various basins across the state of Washington. From this map, produced by the Natural Resource Conservation Service, amounts range from 90 to 95% of normal. We'll look at some individual stations within these areas. These charts show the snow water equivalent, or water held in the snow, for the water year October through September. The blue line is the maximum observed, with the red line the minimum, with the green line the average. Using these charts, we can see how the snow water equivalent accumulates throughout the winter and spring and compare it to average. The Touchet Snotel site is in the Walla Walla Basin, around 5,500 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that snowpack is right near normal for this time of year. The Sassy Ridge Snotel site is located in the Upper Yakima Basin at 4,200 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that this site is slightly below normal for this time of year. The Bumping Ridge Snotel site is at 4,600 feet in the central Washington Cascades. Although the snowpack was slow to start, it has increased and is near normal. Across the state of Oregon, looking at the snow water equivalent map from the Natural Resource Conservation Service, as of January 1st, we can see most basins have received near to slightly above normal snowpack for this point in the year. Amounts range from around 107% of normal in the northeast corner of the state to 120% of normal along the east slopes of the Oregon Cascades. We'll look at some individual sites across the region. For the northern Cascades of Oregon, the Red Hill Snotel site is at elevation of 4,400 feet. Looking at the black line, the current year observation, this location saw a steady accumulation throughout December and is slightly above normal. In the Upper Deschutes Basin, the Three Creek Meadows Snotel site is at about 5,600 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that this location is slightly above normal. For the John Day Basin, we can look at the Blue Mountain Springs site at 5,900 feet. This site saw steady accumulation throughout the month and is near normal. Moving over to the Umatilla Basin in the Blue Mountains, looking at the High Ridge site, it's at 4,900 feet. The black line that we're looking at, we can see that this site is seeing slightly above normal snow accumulations as compared to the green line, the 30-year average. And in the Grand Ronde Basin, the Moss Springs Snotel site at 5,800 feet. We can look at this location and the black line and see that this site is also near normal for this time of year. The Northwest River Forecast Center uses Ensemble Streamflow Prediction, or ESP, generated forecasts as the official water supply method. The 30-year runoff normals cover the years 1981 to 2010 are being used. New ESP forecasts will be published on the Northwest River Forecast Center's website daily. For updated forecasts and more information on the ESP forecasts, please see the River Forecast Center's website on the concluding slide. This map from the Northwest River Forecast Center shows a snapshot of the water supply forecast for the coming season. As of the 1st of January 2017, water supply for the Pacific Northwest looks to be near to slightly above normal. We'll look at several stations within the area for a little more detail. For the Yakima River system, we'll look at the Yakima River near Parker. Looking at the plot, the solid green line is the 30-year normal. The box plots show the entire range of forecast values, with the blue dot the 50th percentile, or most likely value. We'll be using that 50th percentile and comparing it to normal. The volume forecast for the Yakima River near Parker for the period April through September is expected to be slightly above normal at around 110% of normal. The forecasted volume of water for the Grande Ronde River near Troy is expected to be near normal at 108% of normal. These forecasts take into account the forecasted precipitation for the next 10 days and then normal precipitation throughout the rest of the period. For the Umatilla River at Pendleton for the period April through September, the volume forecast is expected to be near normal with 110% of average. Once again, these forecasts take into account the current 10-day forecast, then normal precipitation through the rest of the season. The Columbia River at the Dalles can be an indicator for the entire Columbia Basin. The average value is plotted in green with the most likely value the blue dot. The volume forecast for April through September period is right at average. The previous seen plots and additional water supply locations are available in an interactive form on the River Forecast Center's website at the address listed on the concluding slide. The three-month outlook from the Climate Prediction Center for January, February, and March shows seasonal to slightly below normal temperatures can be expected, with increased chances of above normal precipitation. Once again, additional water supply forecasts can be found at the website listed. And if you have any questions, please contact me either by email or by phone. And please join me again in February for an update on the snowpack and expected water supply for 2017. Thank you.